Hey, everybody.
Welcome, gamers.
Gamers gaming. God. So who we got here today? I think it might just be still us so far. Oh, Brick's
here. Hi, Brick.
Gaming time. So, as per usual, I've gone ahead and gotten us 5 skulls to give to Tarjan for story time. Tale of the Warlord.
It is said that the ancient Jordan tribes were disorganized, rival warlords battling each other for supremacy, until one warlord of the Kalashi tribe saw a more worthy path for her people. She ordered her tribe to leave the Jordan battlefields and focus their skills only on hunting the powerful dragons nearby. The other tribes preyed on the weak around them, the Tuskar, Gnolls, Underdwellers, and in time, they grew weak as well. But the Kalashi grew strong from fighting only the most worthy foes in the Isles. In time, the warlord easily conquered the lazy tribes, uniting their strongest under the Kalashi banner. Focused and forged in battle, the newly emboldened Kalashi led her legendary rampage against the dragons. Never before or since have the Jordan slaughtered so many dragons in a single day. Some Jordan have forgotten the warlord's timeless truth. What you fight, you become. This is why true Kalashi seek out strong opponents, and why weaklings such as you are not worth fighting.
Rude.
We've killed gods, motherfucker.
Oh boy, anyway, let's go get ourselves another baby duck.
Woohoo!
Whack.
Oh, sorry if I yawn a lot. I'm quite tired.
Alright,
as usual.
I still need to change my talents. I forgot to do that. We'll do that another time. The default will be good enough for now. Yum. I will not be doing a world quest. We're not supposed to have unlocked those yet until we finish all 4 zones. Oh, here's one of the things we need to do to unlock Grand Hunts. I guess we'll do that.
Huh.
Hi. Ah, yes. This is a Dragonkin. Can't you tell? Oh, why is...
Uh-oh.
Oh, wait, no, this isn't the right one. This is for... Wrong one, actually. Never mind, goodbye. This is an actual hunt. I thought it was new bag, but it's not. That's Borgazaz. It's another equally incomprehensible name.
Borgazaz?
It doesn't matter, it's a Warcraft name. Somewhere around here should be another ducky. Quack. Oop. Quest mark spotted. Duckling located. This duckling is quacking frantically. If someone doesn't help it, the Gorlocks will surely get annoyed. Maybe the ecologist would know how to help him. The bubble duckling quacks wildly as he leads it away from a certain doom. Here comes the baby. Here comes baby, the baby
approaching.
Baby approaching. Here comes another mouth to feed, Tharu. What a mouth on this one. Quack, quack, quack. He's a quackers, that's for sure. Aha, quack away, dear little quackers. Quackers is certainly a lively little guy, hmm? Thank you for bringing him to us. There can't be too many more out there. You'd think.
You'd think.
This is number 405. Next week we get our last little guy. Daisy, quackers, waddles, a dipper. Look at them. They're just vibing here. Are you guys supposed to be helping them? Anyway, let's head back to Marakai so we can do our Grand Hunt training. Which I keep mentally referring to as the Great Hunt because of Star Wars The Old Republic. Let's see, where are we going? That way. Hey, loop. Also, we've swapped dragons again. This is the one for the Azure span.
Ooh.
So we must hunt creatures, revive injured baby salamanthers, fight some invasive clearwater snappers, and Nubag. It's okay if we kill one if we also revive the other one next to it.
It's fine.
That's how that works. More babies to find. I think there's another one over here. I think. Nope, that was the one that we just saved. Hello. Spin time. Spin to win. Dig up some of those disturbed dirts. I don't remember if I made these on stream or not, but I have a bunch of shovels.
Oh.
They all have 20.
That's a lot of shovels.
They have 20 charges each. It was for leveling my blacksmithing.
God damn.
Oh god, the lag. The infinite dragonflight is at it again. They're messing with time. The Clearwater Snapper is a new bag. Under the dirted. Hello, sir. Epitillion Fang. I think I already have a ruby whelpling. I didn't know they could be in disturbed dirt. But they were from specific treasures. Weird. Where is the dirted? Here's some hair. flail my mouse until I find it. And fight whatever this is. Cat? There it is, it blends right in. Learning things. Oh, this is doesn't count as a beast to hunt. Okay, why not? This one's just a random animal. I'll go back to the coast because I know all those things down there count. Maybe salamander. Ah, for these I have to go up here.
Oh.
Hee hee. Invasive turtle. Yeah, the infinite dragons are at it again. Yee. Yeah, it's just, it's laggy today. I don't know why.
Man.
Other people were having it too. I saw conversations about it before stream started, so.
That's a pretty bad sign.
Yeah, at least we know it's not us.
Yeah, for once.
Weirdly comforting. Toytle's defeated. Oh, new bag is here too? Goodbye. We're just not updated the display. Dirted. Children, this is dirt.
Dirt, 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 dirt.
It's a good post. Ah, there you is. Large duck. Maybe meat. That's such a concerning name for a cooking reagent, is maybe meat.
It really is, just extremely worrying.
And you hook it into probably protein. Excellent. You are ready to join the grand hunts. Please inform this Nessingwary Jr. that there is more to hunting than mindless killing, and that he is unwelcome to join us. What do you mean I failed? There's more to hunting than just mindlessly slaughtered creatures. It wasn't mindless at all. Your mind has to help you aim your gun. Bah, I'll show these Shikar who the real great hunter is. Hemet. Hemet Jr., come on, man.
Come on, man. You're better than this, if you're not.
Oh, I have no world quests being displayed, and yet, I still see the world boss. That's weird.
Huh.
We'll just ignore it. Having a sippy. Anyway, let's head over towards the Azure Span. Except not quite yet, because there's side quests here.
Woo!
Dolly and Dot!
Oh! It's them! It's
the alpacas from Voldoon.
Oh!
And the Volpera are here.
Oh!
I think the game was glitched out and forgot what I was trying to interact with and tried having me pet Nisha for a second. Hello. Hello, Asley of the Artisans Consortium. Hi, 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 you looking for a gig? We're doing a big opening sale for our new crafting order service, and we need to draw attention. But the winds took my flyers, and I think some of the local goats ran off with them. Could you get my flyers back?
Okay.
You seem like a skilled crafter. Would you like to fill some crafting orders for fellow adventurers and get rich, rich, rich? I'll tell you the rules of working with the Artisans Consortium. Blah, 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 yeah, this is tutorial. I don't care. I know this already. Do we want an apron? With a really good texture? Or do we want this when we're mining?
Oh my god.
Now whenever we mine this will pop up.
Woo!
Thomas Bright. Not to be confused with Thomas Light. Show your metal. Yay, free metal.
Woo!
But like, it's definitely a Dr. Light reference, right?
I should double check
to see if... What's... Nah, his husband can't be Dr. Whale because he's Miguel Bright or something. Now, if he was named Albert, that'd be a different story.
Oop, time to hydrate.
Oop.
Hi, Sky.
Thank you for the hydrate and the posture check. And stretch. Pull my arms out of my sockets.
Not recommended, my dude.
I don't need them anymore. I can game with my teeth. Menacing this goat by looking at it. Oh, I charged that 2 inches away.
I know there's some Megman references in True Shot Lodge back in Legion.
Oh, yeah, there was a I think it was Russian Treble.
Yeah.
Also, half of the stuff I know about Mega Man at this point is from the Mega Man Infinite Loops, including a character who isn't real. Make Waltz canon, cowards. Give me the omnicidal roll clone. It is ill-advised to disarm yourself.
That reminds me, I do need to disarm myself real quick. BRB.
Huh. Okay. Oh right, your stretches you gotta do. Maybe me. So how are you all doing in chat? I know it's been a minute since we last streamed, so... Ooh, Draconium. Dink. Dink. And more up there. Ooh, Kazgarite. Even better.
Good is good. This is a meddlesome goat. Do we, wait, do you have the stream on, like, in the background while you're at work? Bro. I mean, I won't tell your boss if you don't, so... Hi, I'd like to make a complaint about one of your employees, a last name Scream, first name Sky. Or is it middle name Scream, last name 3313? This lag. Staring menacingly at these goats with the essence of cheese. Hey, these goats stole our flyers. Go kill them. And we're like, okay. Huh, this goat didn't have a flyer. Oh, well. Guess I'll kill more goats until I find the ones that have them. This is a reasonable, well-adjusted thing to do. I hope there's a quest somewhere, but it's like, Someone's like, hey, can you go take care of such and such and such? You're like, okay, you go and kill them and you come back. Like, what do you mean you killed them?
I'm back.
Hello, welcome back. Sky is at work.
Oh my god, why? I mean, I say like, why are you watching us at work?
Why are you working? Stop being at work. Quit your job. Eat your boss.
Quit your job, join my streamer chat.
Yeah. Priorities, you know. On the other hand, if they have a job, that means they can make money to give us donations.
Oh my god.
Buy a Twitch subscription. Let's see if we can get a rolling pin or a draconium fisher friend. Let's get a fisher friend. We now have a new fishing road. Just goodbye, Underlight Angler. I mean, I'm still going to keep it in my inventory because of who I am as a person, but... Hey, Warrior, got a tick to help with something. Some of our favorite customers placed recrafting orders to the Artisans Consortium, but we haven't heard back from them. If you run into them, can you check to make sure they're satisfied with their purchases? Gotta keep customers happy, happy, happy! Oh, huh. My mount went away. There we go. Hello. Good day being with the trees. The Artisans Consortium wants to know how your recrafting order went. Please tell me. I know if it's lagging.
Please.
I like how half of this is just advertising to the player about, look at this new feature.
No.
Hey, babe, you improved the quality of your necklace by getting it recrafted? Wow. I didn't know you could do that. I'm so glad to learn these things. This guy, this is the guy who keeps stealing our mine, who keeps having those giant mining nodes and being like, back off, this one's mine. They changed their reagents by recrafting your armor? Wow. Incredible. I sure am glad about how the crafting order system works.
Wow.
This man is dead.
Normal.
I take it he must not have been very satisfied with his purchase. Oh no, that's terrible. Azlix pauses for a moment in mourning, then seems to be thinking about what to do with the armor. Well, you know how it's gotta be sometimes. Oh no, bless their soul, Mara looks over the equipment. It's all ruined, spent too long in the elements. Here, take this and craft some new armor. Or speak with being one of the crafting order clerks next to me about Dracula. Reagents.
Woohoo!
My reagent bag is full. Board student. Babies. Some childs. Let's see. Yeah, what am I doing? Something else I wanted to do beyond just the obvious. What was it? I genuinely don't remember. I'm just looking around, being like, what did I want to do again? I buy my junk. That wasn't it, by the way. Was there something else I wanted to do here? I want to put this stuff in the
bank. I have no idea.
Tell me what I was thinking. Love this guy just sells.
Sorry, there's only cobwebs in here.
Maybe there wasn't something I was going to do. Oh well. Main quest. Into the Azure. Come on, game, work with me.
No. Oh no.
Hail, adventurer. I'm glad our call for help reached you. Greetings, Escala. Pakina and I are here on behalf of the Kirin Tor looking for aid. The Kirin Tor are working to safeguard the wild arcane magic located all throughout the Azure span. Kaligos, the aspect of the Blue Dragonflight and one of our leaders, needs aid in reclaiming the Azure Oathstone there as well. If you're willing to help, keep traveling along the road to find Glania of the Blessed Ones. She can direct you to where you can help the most. Glania can help direct you towards the Kirin Tor's efforts in the Azure span. Make sure to tell her Masood and Pakina sent you. Ooh, how many more adventures should we find? Maybe three or four more? Five adventurers seems like a good number to have for any task. Jokes. Ooh, there's a Titan Touch node around here. I would like that. Dink. Dink. Hey, look, a dragon glyph that I've already collected on my main on day one. Oh, someone's being attacked. Yeah, they can handle it.
Fuck 'em.
Anyway, welcome to the Azure Span, or as I like to call it, Northrend 2. I'm sorry, but I do not know how to do this fishing. Can it not wait? If you all insist on examining the fish for this essence, then the least you can do is help me catch some more. Excellent, an adventurer. I can fill you in on the details before I have to learn to fish. The Kirin Tor have our main camp set up to the south of here, Camp Antonitis. I believe Noriko and Khadgar are there now, gathering adventures to aid Kaelic Ghosts in reclaiming the Azure Oathstone. If you wish to help in our endeavors, go there. But first, side quests.
Another pair of hands. I could use some help catching enough fish to bring home for a meal. These Kirin Tor seem concerned about something called magical anomalies in the area, whatever that means. You're all welcome to stay here as long as you pitch in and help out. Grab a fishing pole and start fishing. Many hands make light work.
I don't want that one, though. It sucks. I have my Khazgarite fishing friend, which for some reason doesn't have a line. Don't worry about it.
Good catch.
Look at his fish backpack. Ooh, an Alpha and Dorado. And 1,000 bite piranha. God, my bag is tragic.
Fine work. Have you fished much before?
Not really. Well, I got 100 Legion fishing, so.
That should do it. I've got 5 myself. Kalania, how many do you have?
1. Do I have dialogue turned on? I don't. I'm stupid.
Have you come to tell a tale?
Because I think
it is good to see you.
I realized I missed out on Galani here. I think she's voiced by Laura Bailey.
Oh.
But we missed it because I forgot to turn dialogue on.
Womp womp.
Let me know if you need a few tips.
Your story.
Ah, that will do nicely. Thank you, adventurer.
May your cast land. This is plenty to bring back to Iskara. You both have my thanks.
I fought demons on Argus, survived the trials of the light. I will not leave here until I acquire these accursed fish.
Yeah, that's Laura Bailey, all right. Oh, I remember what I wanted to do back at camp. Now let me just go do that real quick. But yeah, I could tell that's Laura Bailey because there's a bit of a jester slipping in there, I think.
Yeah.
Have you seen some of these creatures in the Unarian Plain?
You.
What has the wind brought? Ride the winds. Look to the skies.
There we go.
Places of the earth.
Greetings. I am Miva Star-Eye, and I'm conducting arcane investigations in this area. The Azure Span has magic all around it. Some of it is benign, while some can be quite dangerous. I've been tasked with ensuring no arcane energies reside in anything that Tuskar possess. We already had one incident in Camp Antonitis of a fishing box spontaneously combusting. Can you take my detector and examine a few objects here? I need to continue speaking with Jolk over here.
Goodbye.
Potential anomalies nearby. Source, flask.
Welcome, welcome.
No arcane energy detected. Next potential source, nearby teapot. No source of arcane energy. Last potential source, child's toy boat. Immense unstable arcane in boat. Risk of explosion, immense.
This boat is mine! Papa got it for me! Leave it alone!
A toy boat that's a magical time bomb? Oh boy. How to stop an exploding toy boat? I am loath to part a child from their toy, but it would be a great value to the Kirin Tor to study how it absorbs so much arcana. Then again, I do not want to slight our No-Tuskar allies. I do have a wand that could dispel the magic. Let's speak with Tulk's mother, then decide what to do.
The day just became more.
Your daughter ran off with a dangerous toy boat. We need to either take it or dispel its magics.
We'll remember you.
I heard everything you said. Tulk has been attached to that boat ever since her father left. Then we have no choice. I cannot separate a child from their father's memento. Escala, take my wand. Tulk could not have gone far. Dispel the boat, then bring everyone back here. She has a hiding spot to the west. Tulk goes there whenever she misses her father. Oh hey, a scroll of blinding speed. Buddy?
Hey Jason!
How come you're glowing so weird? You fixed my boat! Now I can play with it forever and ever! You're the best!
Hi Jason! Oh, the wonders of an exploding boat indeed. The wand can handle any dispelling if we're not too late. We did the right thing. There will be more magical oddities to research, but this girl will not get more gifts from her lost father.
Goodbye.
I'm glad your daughter could hold on to her father's last gift. No magical research is worth that. Last gift?
Guess who has a nice haul of fish from the Gleamlet?
Dad! You've been gone forever!
It's only been a few hours. And guess what? Rurik made you another toy boat.
This one is way cooler than my old boat! Tulk will be the most spoiled girl in all of Iskara if we keep this up.
Miva Star-Eye stares into the distance.
Arcane buildup detected. Source, nearby Torin.
There. There'll be more magical anomalies, I'm sure. Wanted, Gorger. If you're going to be amongst the Tuskar, you would do well to lend a hand. As of late, a beast we call Gorger has been making its home nearby. More of its kind seem to be migrating to this area. This is something we can take advantage of. Kill the Gorger and bring me its horns. We'll need them for building supplies to expand this outpost.
Come back for soon.
Oh, just right over there, okay. You're as good as start throwing hands, yeah. Time to violence. I think the idea was that it was just that one boat that got some wild magic in it. They're not all explodo boats.
They could be.
Yeah, I mean they could be explodo. I hope they're not explodo boats.
3 players recommended. Ha! Do you have the horns?
Careful.
Fine work. We'll put this aside for our future building plans. It is concerning, Gorger and its kind have migrated down here, but we will make the best of it.
I'll pass your story along.
What are you renowned to with the Tuskar? Soon we'll be able to go do feasts. But for now, to Camp Antonitis.
Concerned. We haven't heard back from the patrol up at Ronin's shield.
The magic here is old.
Hi, Khadgar.
Khadgar!
Himpst. Imagine, you're on the battlefield and some guy just chucks a toy boat at you. You stare at it, they stare at you, you stare at it, the boat McFrickin' explodes. This is how you remember it, killed by a tiny toy boat. D&D magic item, anybody? Hey.
I know what to look out for next time we do doip.
Hemet Nessingwary Sr. What's up?
You can't beat the smell of fresh pie.
Hemet Nessingwary, retired. You didn't think retirement would keep me out of the game, did you? My eyes aren't what they used to be, and my hands are certainly less steady, but I can hold these reins. This whole dragon scale expedition is quite the operation, and I have a mind to do my part. As for the Azure Span, well, it reminds me of some of the best places I've ever been. Oh, it reminds him of Northrend too, okay. So you're not here to hunt? I've bagged enough trophies to last me 10 lifetimes. Take Tiny and Junior here. Sure, I could put their heads on a wall as easy as pulling a pint of Don Murrow's Stout, but it'd make my job as a wagon driver significantly harder. I suppose that makes me something of a conservationist.
Hey, be safe out there. Oh, the thrill of a hunt.
I was talking with some hunters out of Iskara the other day, and they mentioned finding a grisly scene. Apparently, a particularly murderous rhino. Ugh, that accent got away from me. Bloodhorn has been devouring the smaller Bruffalon in the area. The Bruffalon have enough competition in Azure Span without worrying about getting their herds thinned out by an invasive brute from out of town. Bring me his horn. I'd like to make a good impression on our Tuskar friends.
I'll be hunting!
And we're just gonna chill here for a while because Hemet has a bunch of quests depending on, he patrols all around the zone, and he has different quests depending on where he is, and we're just gonna get all of them. So we're just gonna go on, welcome to the Grand Tour, Grand Tour.
Nah!
Poem Challenge GT.
How dare you?
Easily. So he has 6 quests.
I hope you like to hunt.
Old Stone Tusk. I have a grim task for you, Escala. Not every kill is a measure of skill. Some are measures of kindness. There's an old bull mammoth wandering the forest east of Camp Antonitis. I saw him from a distance a while back, and I hear his sad trumpeting every so often. Clearly he's in great pain. He started crashing blindly through the undergrowth, and I'm worried he's becoming a danger to others. It'd make my old heart glad if he could put a fellow weary soul to rest. Bring me his tusks so we can honor him.
May your aim be true.
So Hemet is still giving us quests to go hunt things, but it's like for good reasons. Which I think is
wow.
An interesting twist.
Especially compared to his son being a dickhead.
Yeah, who we saw a little earlier, yeah. Anyway, we can swap between sitting in the back and sitting at the front. And, there's no cooldown on this. Goodbye!
Gone forever!
You can still see our shadow!
Oh my god!
Seems like we've hit a height limit, though. Plop. Why is it zooming in when I do it?
Why is the camera zooming in? Why is the camera zooming in?
Goodbye. I guess it wants to try and adjust to our new position.
Our new position in the stratosphere.
Yeah, where it thinks we're going to end up, rather. Blop. Come on, Hammett, let's go.
It's a fine day for a hunt.
I'm returning back to Argus. The portal may be closed, but I'll find a way.
I hope you like to hunt.
Come on, Hammett. We got quests to grab. Come on. Soup star. That's it. Soup star, come and get it, says the chat box. We'll be hit here for a while. Apparently he stops for 5 minutes at a time. Jesus.
Dang.
We'll probably get distracted a little bit once we arrive at our next destination while we wait for him to resume travel. I just want to pick them all up, you know? Hurry up, Hammett. We ain't got all day. Well, here we go.
Hammett, we're streaming!
On the road again, bound to camp nowhere. I know you can go faster than this, Hammett. I know you're just waiting to see if anyone's gonna come in last moment, but they ain't. There we go. Come on, lads, show me what you've got. Kind of reminds me of when, now you might be thinking to yourself, Hammett, why give up the hunt? And I'll tell you. It occurred to me that somewhere between feeding opportunists to firbolgs in winter spring and being strung up in the jungles of Zeldazar, I'd lost me way. The hunt for yourself, for the rush it gives, is a truly selfish thing. It's not for others, it's a thing of beauty. So to answer your question, I haven't given up hunting at all. I'm just more mindful of who I hunt for. And who I hunt with. Anyway, this kind of reminds me of the long carriage rides we would take in Skyrim with the immersive carriages mod thing. Lokir moments. One of these days I should go back to Skyrim and do the Dragonborn DLC with Lokir.
Oh yeah, we never did that.
Yeah. Nasty vampire man goes and finds more things to eat. Oop, hydrate.
Oop.
Hey man, you literally just told this story. I know you have several things you could talk about, but you don't have to do the same one twice in a row, Hammett. Camp nowhere, adventurers and explorers all.
It's a fine day for a hunt.
I heard from one of the guards in Camp Nowhere that there's a nasty piece of work mutilating the local wildlife. It calls itself a hunt master. Hunting is one thing, but I can't abide torturing any living thing. Besides, my wagon could use a good luck charm. That's where he spits over the side. Bring me back its paw.
Hey, be safe out there.
I believe he's going to go from here back to Camp Antonitis, then to Ascara, then back to Camp Antonitis, then to Ronin's Shield, Theron's Watch, and then back to Camp Antonitis.
Damn, alright.
Let's take a few minutes to go get some loot while we wait for Nessingwary to do his thing. Rather than just sitting around. Ah. Oh, Pharaoh Bakar. Bad dogs. Ooh, a centaur hunting trophy. Here's some ore. It's a Tuskar tackle box. And hey, some otters. Boing. Look at this, look at this guy.
Yeah.
Backing up, getting a running start. Boing!
Aww.
The little things. Oh no, there's a misaligned lay crystal here. Can't have that now, can we? Excellent! You found another misaligned ley line. Restoring the uninterrupted flow of magic is crucial for the Azure Span's recovery. Hi, Kalik. We've definitely talked about this before. Anyway, this is the Blingtron minigame from Legion. And now it's an aligned Lay Crystal. Wait, did Hemet leave?
Gone forever!
I thought he was there for 5 minutes! Either that or just didn't see him. Swear to God, if I find him back at Camp Antonitis. Hi, Hammett. Okay, I guess we're not waiting all day. Hey, look, someone in the background flying, and they're gone.
She's doing her best.
What I should have done is I should have pulled up Dueling Drama Much, you know?
Oh, God.
It's not too late, I suppose.
The threat of tradition looms over us.
I did find where we were up to in Dueling Drama Much.
Oh my God.
Why
does everyone have trouble with the name of our people? It sounds just like it is spelled. How exactly do you crash into a planet? That's what I want to know. Stop and ask for directions, I told him. But no! It's interdimensional, he says. What can go wrong? Single Dranai female seeks blacksmith with grinding wheel to take care of me and my gorgeous hooves.
Oh my god.
Ascala, you are a blacksmith.
That's what I was thinking.
Here we go. Ascala, here we come. Tally-ho! He probably said it more enthusiastically than that. But whatever, man. Anyway, the reason I want to pick these all up now is in case he's not nearby when I'm actually at the areas that these quests are at. I don't want to miss him. Because he does travel.
Makes sense.
We are at 3 of 6 right now, I believe. We have Protect and Herd. We have Old Stone Tusk, we have Hunting the Hunt Master. We need Shadow in the Ice, Pruning the Pack, and the Face of Death. You know, there was a time when people scoffed at the idea of a dwarf hunter. They said we were too short, that our guns and our gazes were too close to the ground. I've trained many young hunters who put that stupid old myth to bed, but none more so than the gnome Addie Fizzlebog. Now there's a lass who knows her business. Whether with book or blunderbuss, she's pound for pound my equal in every way. I wonder what she's up to these days. You remember Addie from Legion in High Mountain? Has been a bit. I'm glad you respect her as his equal, considering she got trained in Legion.
Yeah.
By us. Anyway, the Azure span is so pretty. And it's the first one again. Damn it, please! I wonder how many people misread his name as Helmet Nessingwary.
I mean, I kept, literally until today, misreading his last name was Nestingwary, so...
Helmet Nestingwary. Completely original character.
Helmet Nestingwary.
It's like one of those characters you see in one of those, like, blatant rip-off, mobile games.
Yeah.
Because what's a copyright law? Ascala, a cold place with a warm welcome. Try not to slip. So while we wait... Chapter 3, Seeker of Cards. So last time, Mikey and Sabrina's baby got kidnapped, and one of the spies is dueling some warehouse guy, I think? I don't remember.
I don't know, it's been over a year, I think.
Too long. Author's notes. As this fic was made in 2007, and is the second season, I want the time zones and cards made from both series, and so, real world to be held in respect. Therefore, expect these conditions in the following duels. No cards from 5Ds and Zale allowed. They didn't exist then. Only vintage cards from Yu-Gi-Oh! Eps 1 to 97. Only GX cards from episode 1 to 52 are permitted. Any card released in packs higher than 2007 are not permitted. Why is he saying like it just didn't exist yet? Why is he acting like they're illegal? I know this is reposted in 2016, but...
Bro?
Card names will be in bold italic capitals when played for the first time. Card names that are underlined means the card can be found in our world, but I'm using its anime effect. Card names with a strike through means the card is from the anime / manga only. It doesn't exist in our world.
That would just make it, like, unreadable if you give a strike through. That's incredibly jarring. Like, I could have used the bold and italics because it's fucking Yu-Gi-Oh, but strike through? Why are you redacting a card from existence?
Chapter 3. From their secret hideout, the two siblings were presented with little Erica, who had cried herself to sleep, which the sister was planning to adopt as her own child. She never felt so happy and giddy before. "Congratulations, sister," her brother said with pride. "Our plan is working." His sister held the little bundle close to her, "and soon I shall have her father by my side as well. While you may do as you wish to his soon-to-be ex-wife." Jesus, that's a start. Her brother snickered at the thought, but he was snapped out of his trance when another rare hunter entered the chamber to deliver a message to the leaders that one of their hunters, Seeker, was preparing to duel someone. The siblings did not wish to miss this, and the two objects they held glowed brightly, allowing them to witness the duel through their hunter's eyes. Is this supposed to be like Merrick and Ishizu, but Ishizu is evil?
I think so. I think that's what the conclusion he came to before.
Why did you make Ishizu evil?
I don't know. She has boobs. Context. It's fucking Mikan.
Yeah. Dot, dot, dot. Seeker and Clover stood at opposite ends away from one another in a wide-open area of the room, and Seeker was kind enough to lend Clover a duel disc from one of his fallen teammates to use for the match. I know it would have been funny if they pulled a Yu-Gi-Oh! Go Rush and just had Clover just dueling on a cardboard box. Sam and Alex repeatedly tried to talk Clover out of it, but Clover insisted on going ahead. "I'm ready. Let's do this." Seeker laughed at Clover. "I admired your courage, but I'm afraid all the bravery in the world won't save you from the hunter's sting. Let's begin." Hi, Wesso, where we're doing dueling drama much while we're waiting for this carriage.
Yeah.
Score: Seeker 8,000 versus Clover 8,000. No, this is totally Spy's Yu-Gi-Oh! Crossover fanfic. With a character that is definitely not the author's self-insert, even though he has the same name and is super idealized, because he said that he's just an OC. And let's also not worry that anytime it shows up, it's in first-person omniscient narration, with referring to him as I in the narration. Don't worry about it. It's totally not a self-insert. Because he said so. Oh no. Seeker 8000 versus Clover 8000. With the scores already set and the discs powered up, Sam and Alex decided to cheer Clover on, which she liked. Okay, time to throw down. I summon Elemental Hero Avion.
No!
That was why I said, oh no, is I saw...
I hate it here.
No. She's only based on Sabrina from Pokemon. It's not actually Sabrina from Pokemon. He said so a few chapters ago. Don't worry about it. Original character.
You're not steel.
Attack 1000. She was because she had the Millennium Necklace. And then Mikan got it, because of course he did.
Was it the necklace or the puzzle?
It was the necklace.
Okay.
She ended her turn without playing any other cards, in hopes of luring her opponent into the open. But Seeker snickered and began his turn. I shall set one monster in face-down defensive mode, and my turn is complete. Oh, God. Clover and the others didn't understand why he did
that. Oh, thank God, the cart is moving.
Avion was a weak monster. What's the matter? Too scared to fight like a man? Clover Mocker.
Mocker?
Mocker. M-O-C-K-E-R. Mocker.
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 Mocker. This bit gives me brain damage.
I think he had brain damage when he was writing this. You know?
I still can't believe you actually, like, lost to him in an online duel.
I can't believe I actually dueled Mikan and lost.
You got OTK'd, even.
I lost to the author of this fic in a duel in Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist. I just went to the online lobby for the first time. I see Dakari King Mikan in the online lobby, and I'm like, ha, wouldn't it be funny if that was really Mikan? So I dueled him. He beat me. And then I messaged Mikan on DeviantArt like, hey, is that you? And he was like, yup, here's how I won. Here's the combo I used. And it was right. It was really him.
God.
Clover Mocker. Seeker snickered again. I? Afraid? Certainly not, but soon you will be running scared from the hunter like the hunted. Make your move. Whatever, said Clover as she drew her next card and liked it.
Great.
Let's see how you like this. I activate polymerization. Now I can fuse together Avain with Burstinatrix. To perform Elemental Hero Flame Wingman. Attack 2100. Clover's new monster appeared and blazed in flame. She then ordered her monster attack and destroyed the face-down Giant Soldier of Stone with ease. Ha! My monster was in defense mode, so my life points are made untouched, Seeker gloated. Actually, Flame Wingman has a special ability, Clover said. No, this guy's infamous enough that he has a TV Tropes page. When he destroys a monster, you take damage equal to the amount of attack points that monster had, and that's 1300. Seeker gasped and braced himself as the holographic flames enveloped him, and his score dropped. Score, Seeker 6,700 versus Clover 8,000. Sam and Alex cheered for Clover, and she gave them a huge thumb up. Now I'll throw down a face down and end my turn. Is she just talking like Jaden because she's playing Elemental Heroes?
I hate it here.
Is that
it? This is stealing so much. I've been watching the GX dub with Jorb, and this is doing me so much damage as a result.
I mean, season one of this had all the Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Monsters cards.
But I hadn't.
Mikan had a Dark Magician.
Any part of season one?
Mikan had Dark Magician. There was a point where they had a tag duel against the Paradox Brothers for some reason. One of the girls has red eyes as their ace. Oh, and they also got all the custom cards at the end. It's like all the Spy Girl cards that's based on themselves.
Yeah.
Is that all? I was expecting more from you. Seeker mocked. Clover was really getting tired of all his taunting and hooting.
Hooting.
Will you just move so I can get back to smacking you? She growled. As you wish, Seeker hissed as he drew his next card. I predict my card shall be Pot of Greed. And he played his card without even looking at it, surprising everyone that it was indeed Pot of Greed, allowing him to draw two more cards. How did he know what card that was? He didn't even look at it, Clover thought in her mind. Who is this guy, really? Where else would you think other than in your mind? Yeah, I'm wondering if he's playing the Mai thing or if he just got marked cards. Sam was wondering the same thing. I don't think I really trust this guy. Aw, come on, Sammy. Clover's winning, and you can't argue with that, said Alex. And while she had a point, the duel still wasn't over, and Seeker liked what he drew a whole lot.
Why does he keep using that phrasing?
For my next
one. And she liked it.
And she liked it.
I hate it here.
You can't just... Your characters can't just say how they feel. That makes me feel angry.
By the way, we're somewhere else now.
Yeah, but he has no more quests for us, so I have to keep waiting until he moves again.
Great.
I have WoW up as well. I can see the game, so...
Okay, I couldn't tell.
No, I'm keeping an eye. For my next move, I'll throw this monster in defensive mode, and I'll place one card face down on the field as well. That ends my turn. Again with the defense? Asked Clover. Ever heard of attacking? Seeker only chuckled. Eager to lose, are we? The hunter will strike when the time is right, and not before. Yeah, it is literally cheating. You're correct. Clover rolled her eyes, but drew her next card, and felt confident that her next plan would succeed. Time to beef up my army some more. I activate Fusion Recovery, so now I can take back Avion and Polymerization from my graveyard, and, you guessed it, now I activate Polymerization to fuse my recovered Avion with Bubble Man, so I can create Elemental Hero Mariner. Attack 1400. Now Clover had two super-fused heroes by her side. Seeker didn't seem too thrilled, though, that when Clover ordered Flame Wingman to attack the face-down monster, he laughed at her. Sorry, my dear, but I'm afraid Spirit Reaper cannot be destroyed in battle by any monster. Clover was outraged that her attack failed, but she wasn't too worried. I still have my Mariner, and get this, as long as I have face downs in my spell trap zone, he gets to go and attack you directly. Seeker gasped, and before he knew it, he got struck hard again and was dealt another 1400 points of damage. I'm pretty sure she doesn't have a set card, though. Seeker set a card, she hasn't.
Yeah.
Cheating! 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 Score. Seeker, 5,300 versus Clover, 8,000. That was for calling me a fox earlier. Oh, right. At the end of the last chapter, he referred to her as a fox as an insult, and she really disliked it for some reason. As like a taunt.
It's not her right persona.
Wrong persona, yeah. You go, girl. Clean his clocks off, cheered Alex.
What?
I think you mixed up Cleta's clock and knocked her socks off and combined them into one. Clover turned and gave her another thumb up. I'll end my turn by throwing down a face down. You know.
Cleta's clock's right off.
He's multiple clocks. Oh yeah, in season one, at the beginning of season one, Mikan, who was their history professor, decided to throw out the entire curriculum and teach them the rules of Yu-Gi-Oh. So that's how they know.
This has already broken me.
Seeker recovered from the attack. Nice move. Perhaps I underestimated you at the start. But don't think for 1 minute this means you've escaped the hunt. Stop talking about the hunt!
He prepared to draw his card and played it again without even looking at it.
I play graceful charity. Now I may draw 3 cards and then discard 2. I'm a bit concerned. We haven't heard back from the patrol
at Ronin's shield. Okay, great.
Great.
He did it again, Sam snapped in her mind. He didn't even look at that card, yet he knew exactly what it was. And now I'll reveal my face-down trap card, Jar of Greed, so I may draw yet another card.
Clover was most irritated. Hello?
Is Pot of Greed banned now?
Oh, Pot of Greed has been banned for ages.
Oh.
It's...
Huh.
Hey, new quest. I've heard whispers while passing through Camp Antonitis. Talk of mutilated fauna being found across the icy steps. Some nothing more than bloody splatters. Whatever it is, it's got the mages scared and made the local wildlife scarce. Poke around the top of the glacier. If I was a betting dwarf, I'd say that's where any apex predator worth its salt would stake its claim. Bring me a piece of it so we can soothe the Kirin Tor. Okay, 2 more. Back to dueling drama much.
Blood.
Clover was most irritated. Hello, getting bored over here. All you've done is play defenses and draw. If I didn't know any better, I'd say you've a pretty lame deck going on there. Seeker snickered at that remark.
Very well then, perhaps it is time I came out from the shadows and started to chase.
Great.
I summon Mooka Mooka.
Hey, you know that's you know this one, you saw this the other day.
Attack 600.
Clover was confused as to why he played such a lame monster, only to find out that it gained 300 attack points for every card Seeker was holding. Why was that narration?
Since I'm holding 6 cards in my hand, my monster's attack increases by 1,800, giving it 2,400 attack points.
Whoa, didn't see that coming, cried Clover. Sam and Alex felt shivers run down their spines. I like the phrase, they each have multiple spines.
None of Clover's monsters were strong enough to take the hit from that beast. Time for the hunter to pounce, sneered Seeker. Go, my monster!
Hold it right there, snapped Clover. I activate my trap. A hero emerges!
What's this? Snarled Seeker. Now he was forced to pick a card from Clover's hand, and if it was monster, it would get summoned to the field, except Clover was holding only one card.
You wanted to see my rarest card, and now here it comes. Red Spy Girl! Oh, here we go.
Attack 2300. The very card I had made especially for and given to Clover a year ago, and the only one of its kind.
Mikan, you're not even in this scene!
Where did this come from?
You can't use first-person omniscient when you're not there.
Me, I do this.
I do this.
I do this.
It's me, Mikan. I do this.
Seeker was amazed. He had never seen a card like this before, and he was more amazed at how strongly it looked like Clover herself.
So, you managed to summon your rarest monster. You still can't stop my attack.
Actually, I can, snapped Clover, thanks to my other face-drowned trap, Hero Barrier. Since I've got elemental heroes in play, your attack is called off.
Seeker's attack was nullified, and he clenched his fists in anger. Oh, actually, he does work in Industrial Illusions as of the end of the last fic, I think.
Oh, yeah. God... Fuck.
My monsters are still impenetrable from your monster's attacks. They are no threat to me.
Clover drew her next card. You know, you sure like to be wrong a lot, she gloated. Maybe I should show you my spy girl special ability. Yeah, it's nepotism. Her spy girl's body glowed brightly as Clover paid half her life points. Score, Seeker 5300 versus Clover 4000. And suddenly, all of Seeker's monsters shattered. My monsters, he shouted. You destroyed them all! Aw, yeah, who's the fox now? Clover cheered. Again, somehow that's supposed to be a negative thing. Sadly, since I used her effect, Red Spy Girl can't attack. But you two can, she shouted at Flame Wingman and Mariner, and told them to go for it in a combo attack on Seeker's life points, dealing him a whopping 3,500 points of damage, and almost knocked him off his feet. Score, Seeker 1,800 versus Clover 4,000. Clover was just an unstoppable loudmouth of cheers. Say my name! Say my name! She chanted. Sam and Alex felt Clover's victory was assured, but Seeker drew his next card and laughed hysterically. What's that freak so happy about? Asked Alex. Seeker stood tall and proud and looked Clover dead in the eyes. You've done impressively well to make it this far, my dear, but just as I knew from the very start, you were doomed to fail against me. Clover blinked twice in extreme confusion. Fail? Me? Hello, you're the one who's losing the duel here. Seeker remained unfazed by her deduction. You may have a good ideal of dueling, but you have much to learn about rare hunters like myself. I may be low on life points, but that doesn't mean I can't still pull through. He then revealed 5 of his 7 cards to the girls and swiftly placed them on his disc. I summon Exodia, the Forbidden One!
What?
Shrieked Clover. No way, cried Alex. Not Exodia, added Sam. But sure enough, the huge monster appeared in the eerie summoning. Clover was panicking to extreme anxiety, trying to find some way out. But she knew just as well as the others there was nothing she could do. I'm toast, she cried. Seeker snickered and ordered his final assault. Exodia, obliterate! And Exodia unleashed his extreme power, blasted Clover's monsters and all her life points to total nothingness. Final hyphen score. Seeker 1800 versus Clover, quote, 0000, end quote. Clover screamed and held her arms up as the huge shockwaves blazed past her and knocking her far back and slamming her into a wall. All her cards scattered about with just a few left on the disc, including the Spy Girl card. Clover, cried Sam as she and Alex dashed over to help her up. Are you okay? Asked Alex. Do I look okay to you? Cried Clover. My hair, my nails, my everything. You get it? Because she's girl. She's girl, remember? Seeker stepped forth laughing at her, and worst of all, the other fallen hunters rose back up to their feet. What? Much to the girl's horrors. I told you, you were never a match for me, with a capital M, hissed Seeker, and explained to the spies how his entire deck was built to summoning Exodia, while at the same time keeping his opponent stalled and himself safe. No one has ever defeated my unstoppable strategy, and no one ever will. That's beside the point. You lost our duel, and that entitles me to take your rarest card, the Red Spy Girl. Clover grabbed her card and held it with pride. Forget it! Deal's off! Fool! I didn't give you a choice! The hunters surrounded the spies, and before the spies could retaliate, they suddenly felt their bodies freeze up. What's happening? Groaned Sam. I can't move! Cried Alex. Before anything else happened, the girls were beaten up brutally!
Oh my god!
And Seeker snatched Clover's Red Spy Girl card, as well as the downloaded profits he stole from the factory's computer systems. Once again, the mighty hunter seizes victory. My masters will be pleased. Farewell, and he and his gang left the building. Oop, quest. Nessing wary gestures to the side of the path. See those imprints in the snow? Yeti tracks. Something must have riled them up to hunt this close to the road. See if you can hunt down their pack leader. We don't want them to start ambushing travelers. If he's a particularly mean brute, collect his head. That should dissuade the others.
Yep, hold on.
I can get therapy, please. Yeah, a little bit.
Hi, dinner's ready, so I'll be going in a bit. Not right now, because I have to cool off, but,
I guess I'll be reading more DDM, then.
You're not rid of me just yet.
Yeah. The second they were gone, the spies felt they could move again, but they felt really horrible after all that, especially Clover. No, my red spy girl, she groaned. She felt like bursting into tears. It felt as if she had lost a part of herself with her card. There's nothing we can do right now, Clover, said Sam. We better get back to Whoop, Alex suggested. Jerry's never gonna believe this. And that's the end of the chapter.
Great.
But I guess there's gonna be another one, because you're going to dinner.
Not yet! I just said...
I mean, we're also still waiting on the cart, so.
Rick.
Ooh, Sky's got pizza. Epic. Still need the face of death at Theron's watch.
I'm dying, Squirtle.
Squirtle.
Why is my Tumblr blogs refusing to reorganize? I've shuffled this around like 3 times.
Hmm. Chapter 4. You are invited. Chapter 4. The Seeker and his rare hunters reported back to their masters to tell him of their victory. But the masters were already aware of it. However, they seemed more disappointed than pleased. I don't understand. I won. I seized a rare card, said Seeker. Yes, you did, said the brother. However, my sister and I could see through to the other girls who were with the one you defeated, and they have identical rare spy cards as the one you took. Seeker gasped softly and realized he could have beaten Sam and Alex had taken their cards as well. Forgive me, masters, but you understand I was in a hurry. Silence, shouted the sister. There will still be yet another chance for you to make up for this blunder. Do not disappoint us again. Meanwhile, at Mandy's house, poor Mandy.
Oh, I forgot she existed.
Capitalized P, poor Mandy, was sitting in her room sulking angrily. She, too, had graduated from Mali U, just like the spies did. Only with very low marks. No prestigious job offers or privileges. Her mother was very disappointed in her and made her take extra, yet private, homeschooling courses to help boost her status, to which bored her to death.
Oh my god.
Other times...
Damn, sucks to be her.
Other times, while she wasn't shopping or dating... because she's a girl,
yeah?
She spent her time dueling, and despite her nasty attitude, she was still a fairly excellent player and crushed every opponent in her path. But still, crushing all those losers and wannabes, as she put them, didn't put her spirits right, and she already knew why. It was... it was because of Clover, Sam, Alex, and especially me... The way we constantly clobbered her in every duel since I defeated her at Mali U. Viking, you're not in the scene. Go away.
Fuck off.
Again, like I said, first person omniscient. Oh, God. It's certainly a choice. But it's okay, he's totally not a self-insert character, you guys. Totally.
Totally.
Mandy wanted nothing more than to get revenge on me and the girls for humiliating her. But no matter how hard she tried, and the many times she restacked her deck with all the rare and powerful cards she could find, she just couldn't win. The worst part was that she couldn't see the real reason of her failures, was that she refused to acknowledge her selfish and obnoxious attitude, playing only for power and glory instead of dueling with honor and respect. She merely dismissed it was because the girls had powerful, super rare cards, like those spy girls I made for them. Mandy angrily threw her pillow at the wall and growled. If only I had a super rare card like that, maybe even more, I'd show those dweebos who deserves to be the strongest.
Dweebos.
Yes, no, quote, me in this case is the character Mikan. Not to be confused with the author Mikan, he says that the character Mikan is not a self-insert. He promises, swears, the character Mikan is not a self-insert. She was snapped out of her trance by her mother coming in and telling to go get the mail, which she was told to do so hours ago. But mom, don't but mom me, young lady. Now go. I think we're about to get to our last quest here. Oh, we're not actually there yet. Whoops. I thought we were pulling up. We are not. Mandy did as she was told, grumbling angry to herself, and she found a letter from her father who was working overseas. It read how he missed her and knew she was feeling a bit low in the chop, feeling a bit low in the chops about duel monsters and stuff.
What?
I've never heard that expression before.
What? I need to Google that. Hold on.
She was feeling a bit low in the chops. You know. But he told about a tournament he had heard of that was soon to begin and suggested she enter it. In addition, there was a
This isn't real!
Mikey just invented an expression. And Mandy's father had written that some of his men he sponsored for an archaeological dig had found it, and he thought she should have it to give her deck a much needed boost.
I googled that phrase, like,
it's not real.
Low in the chops, and it told me, like, this is what the resource is about. Here's what I do if you have depression, and here's how to tell if your pork chops are bad.
How to tell if your pork chops have depression. Tell me, friend, have you ever seen the face of death? Nestingwary pauses for dramatic effect. What am I saying? Of course you have. Death, after all, has many faces. I've heard tell from the Imbu Tuskar that one of its faces lives up in these hills. To even say its name is to invite a violent, frigid death. Frostjaw. Nestingwary looks around warily. Well, now you have to hunt it, for my sake at least.
Hey, be safe out there.
Okay, and that's the last one. Now we can take a flight path back to, Camp Antonitis, and I'll continue with DDM.
Yes.
Oh my god, Jesus. This person is a loser for thinking having more power would solve our problems. Unlike me, who writes ungodly amounts of self-insert fanfic about me being super amazing at everything.
Oh yeah, the character Mikan is like, he's got like a PhD. He's like in his like late teens, early 20s. He has a PhD. He's incredibly attractive. He's the youngest teacher ever at the school. He can get away with just throwing away the entire curriculum to teach everybody about duel monsters for his ancient Egypt lessons. He was engaged to a princess, Sabrina. Got a hold of one of the Millennium items, which lets him see the future. And more. What is this? She wondered as she gazed at the card. It was unlike anything she had ever seen.
except for maybe all of the other Yu-Gi-Oh cards. It wasn't even listed in the official book of current existing cards. There's a list of every card? In a book?
Does it include the Spy Girls?
Does it include the Spy Girls? And yet,
how often is it updated?
I don't know. And yet, after reading its text and studying its effects, she felt a nasty, wicked smile come onto her face when she thought of all the possibilities and the hope that this was what she had been waiting for, and she decided to test it out by entering the tournament she heard of. Yu-Gi-Oh! Wiki. Meanwhile, the spies got back to Whoop, and Jerry was indeed shocked to hear of the events that happened, and felt especially sorry for Clover losing her card, but he felt just the same as Alex and Sam did. You should never have agreed to that match, Clover. Yeah, I've heard it enough, Clover barked. Jerry winced as if he had come face to face with a cobra. Clover apologized, but she was really peeved. Losing her card and getting beat up by those thugs. I still wonder who they are and what do they want, said Sam. I want to know how they are able to freeze us up like that, said Alex. It felt like magic.
Wow, right.
Convenient you could tell that. Sam looked at the computer images of the rare hunters and suddenly realized suddenly realized the markings on the hunters' foreheads. That's the mark of the Millennium Items. The others realized she was right, and they thought maybe I would know something about this. We've got to call Mike in now, said Alex.
Call
911. Since I was an honorary Whoop agent, Jerry contacted me and Sabrina by video phone, and they caught us at it as a very bad moment. Sabrina looked as if she had been sobbing for hours, which she had. And I told the gang why, and you can bet they didn't know how much more devastation they could take. How could they just kidnap a sweet little baby? Alex cried, trying not to sob. That's not all they took, I said. We found a few of our card storage lockers broken into and cleared out. A great number of rare and newer cards missing. We found all the guards unconscious, and this was defiantly the work of Millennium Magic. This case was getting more and more serious than ever. Can't you use your items to look into the past or future? Asked Sam. King Wilhelm shook his head. Oh, I guess he's there too.
What the fuck?
Sabrina's dad, who is also totally not Pegasus. We've tried, but whoever did this is somehow blocking us from seeing those events. And what's worse, we couldn't even see this coming or why it happened. Sabrina, trying her best to keep her head, showed the spies the note that was left behind when Erica was taken away. It read, "If you ever want to see your precious baby again, you'll both participate in our dueling tournament we will be hosting. But you can make it easier and surrender yourselves immediately to us. P.S. If you have the rare card we seek, be sure to bring it with you. Signed, the Rare Hunters." Wait, are the Rare Hunters running Battle City instead of Kaiba this time?
Oh my god.
Okay, will someone clue me in as to who these Rare Hunter dudes are? Asked Clover. The others all wanted to know this as well. So I decided to tell them the story. It dated all the way back to ancient Egypt.
Oh, fuck off.
I just dramatically put my hand out. In the days when duel monsters were real and such. But not having been the girls' college teacher all that long, we never got to that subject. The Rare Hunters. They were, in ancient times, a band of thieves who made a living by stealing valuable treasures, weapons, anything rare and powerful they took a liking to, with two O's, and would sell them to high bidders to get rich and smite their enemies. These power-hungry mongers were eventually caught up with and executed by good kings.
What?
By good kings.
By good kings.
By good
executing
kings.
Executing people.
No, I'm pretty sure it is consistently first person for him.
However, in modern days, the rare hunters... yes, good kings support the death penalty, exactly. However, in modern days, the rare hunters relate more to the Duel Monsters card game. They find it relatable. They specialized in rare and powerful cards, which they steal or accumulate from others, and sell them on the black market or to high bidders. However, they keep the strongest cards for themselves to build extremely powerful decks, rendering them seemingly unstoppable. Even still, that didn't explain a thing as to why they were robbing businesses of money. They literally just said they were selling rare things for money. Why would they rob businesses for money? What could you do with money anyway? That useless money, all we need is trading cards. Kaiba holding a $5 bill. What is this? Can you summon it? But it was obvious the work of whoever was behind the Millennium Magic. So they're being controlled by someone who has a Millennium item, said Sam. That's... Oh god, I forgot that character's name. This sounds almost exactly like what happened last year. You know, when we freed the king from that evil monster, Azwad. Added Alex.
No!
I forgot that was his name!
Oh no!
That's A-S-W-A-D. Azwad.
Azwad.
The money can be exchanged for trading cards.
Sounds fake.
Homer Simpson just... Wilhelm didn't like being reminded of it, as it reminded him of all the horrible things he did to others against his will. But we still forgave him, as it wasn't really his fault, but the evil of Azwad. He was long gone now. Still.
Man.
I guess we don't have any other option, I said. We'll have to compete in this tournament to get Erica back. Or you could, like, contact
the
police.
Call the cops?
Yeah. Actually, I'm just thinking of that one GX episode in the middle of the Shadow Riders arc where they do, in fact, just get law enforcement involved.
Oh, yeah.
But then it turns out that it was actually just another one of the, another one of the Shadow Riders anyway. Just imagine explaining to the police that, yeah, so we here at this card game school, we have these very rare cards that are really dangerous cards, and some bad guys are trying to get their hands on these cards, so they're playing card games with our students to try and get these keys we're guarding, so that they can use all the dual energy to activate the keys so they can get these rare cards. We need the police to deal with this. Why did they hang up? But it's so important for the fate of the world that they don't get these trading cards. Don't they understand?
Yeah, no, there is a kidnapped child.
There is a kidnapped child.
A literal baby.
Yeah. Sabrina agreed. Those rare hunters will pay for what they've done to us. You could count me in too, said Clover. I owe these guys one for taking my card from me, and I'm not going to rest until I get it back. Wait, is this supposed to parallel Joey losing his red eyes to one of the rare hunters?
Oh my god.
Alex wanted in too. No one hurts my friends and gets away with it. If you're going, then I'm going too, said Sam. I was very happy to hear them say that. Jerry almost felt like crying. Never have I seen a more charismatic demonstration of friendship and honor. Never has he seen a more charismatic demonstration of friendship and honor.
Never ever.
Wilhelm wanted to join too, but felt he had to stay behind to help clean up the messes left around the palace. As well as be... Surely you guys have, like, janitors? Why would the king be cleaning up the okay. As well as be ready if the rare hunters dared to strike the island again and grab any more cards. Oh right, this place is also like a fusion of Duelist Kingdom and Duel Academy for some reason. So it was decided. The girls would sign up for the tournament, and we were all in this together now to save my baby and the world from financial collapse.
What?
When was that on the table?
Hello?
Financial collapse? Alright, sure, that could be a stake now.
Sure. Alright.
The tournament was conveniently going to be held in Beverly Hills City.
What?
I guess that's the setting, but God. How convenient. And practically every duelist in town wanted to sign up, but tonight was the last night to sign up. People could sign up for the tournament online, and those who didn't possess dual discs of their own would be given one on the day of the tournament after entry. Beverly Hills City. The girls stayed up half the night cramming, studying up on cards, going through their decks, and deciding what to change and restack. Restack? Are they stack? That's not a term! They even went over the rules of the tournament, and everything seemed pretty much straightforward. And the first place prize for the tournament was $10 million!
Sorry, I just saw this world operates on the royal baby standard!
Second place would receive $5 million, and third place received $3 million. Aren't the rare hunters hosting this tournament? Is this why they stole the money so they have a prize pool?
I guess.
Are they actually intending to give this money away, or is it all fake? Oh, next paragraph. As much as the girls thought that cool, they had a feeling that money was probably from the amount stolen from the businesses, but it was defiantly a surefire way to attract duelists to signing up. Again, not definitely, defiantly. There was also, however, one thing bothering everyone. There was a new anti-rule, whereas the loser of each duel would be forced to hand over the rarest, most powerful card in their decks to the winner. That is totally bogus, growled Alex. We should have expected this. After all, it's the Rare Hunters tournament, said Sam. Great, now we just may lose more of our cards? Wineclub. That was a thing in Battle City, yeah, you had to give your rarest card to the winner if you lost.
But why is it called an anti-rule?
A-N-T-E.
Oh! Oh! Sorry, I was just like, this is the inverse rule. This inverse is the opposite of rules.
Sorry. I could have imagined Mike spelling it like that.
Listen, this is doing drama. For all I know, that could have been real.
I feel bad for anyone in Magic the Gathering who'd lost their Black Lotus to an ante.
Oh my god.
The girls really took some time to think about it now. They already had lost one rare card and didn't know if it was worth the risk to lose more. But suddenly they remembered that the fate of the world was on the line!
What the fuck?
And they promised to help me and Sabrina get Erica back. So they decided no turning back. Besides, Clover couldn't wait for a chance to find Seeker and make him regret messing with her. Why is the fate of the world on the line? All they've done so far is steal money and steal a baby.
I'm getting a bit concerned.
Dialogue, okay. So they signed up and received an immediate answer that they were invited to participate, and were instructed to print out the letters of approval to present at the registration. Then, over the next 2 days, the girls devoted their every waking spare second to stacking and restacking their decks. What do you think that means, Mikan? Because saying that you're stacking the deck means you're cheating and you're putting them in a specific order. And even bought a few new booster packs to help them. Sabrina and
They're
I were...
They're gonna go insane.
Sabrina and I were doing the same. We even had warm-up duels between each other, and her father dueled with us too to keep us going. However, I decided that I would have to leave my own Exodia set behind. Oh, right, because that would be too overpowered narratively. I couldn't let the rare hunters get them by their anti-rule, and they were also cluttering my deck with the new cards I stacked. You keep using that word! On top of it all, what good was it if I kept relying on Exodia to win my duels? Full deck.
Kidnap a bunch of babies, tattoo a card on each, have a full deck of live babies!
And now I shuffle my deck! I send this baby to the graveyard! My baby attacks you directly. The whole point of Duel Monsters was experimenting and practicing with many strategies. This left my Dark Magician, my favorite card, as my rarest and most valuable. As much as it pained me for risking it in my upcoming duels, it was well worth the risk for any hopes of getting Erica back and finding who was behind all this madness. I just... Alright, that's the end of that chapter. I'm gonna keep going! Screw World of Warcraft! Oh no. Chapter 5. Welcome to Duel City.
I destroy my baby!
Bold of you to assume Mikan is capable of reproduction. Remember, this is not Battle City, everybody. This is the completely original arc, Duel City.
Great.
Completely original. Chapter 5. Soon, the big day arrived. Tons of duelists arrived in which was nicknamed Duel City that morning. The promise of prize money sure attracted a lot of duelists. The spies arrived early for their registration, and they already had duel discs, but in addition, they and everyone also received what appeared to be fragments of some kind of clear, see-through card. But not a single person knew what it was for. Okay, it's the locator cards, because it's Battle City. I think it's some kind of puzzle, Sam suggested as she noted her piece looked different than Alex and Clover's, but there was still nothing to tell what it was. While things were still just setting up, the girls looked all around trying to find me or Sabrina, but it was hard to spot us through such a big crowd, especially when the girls got easily distracted by all the cute boys they saw roaming about.
Great.
Because they're girls! Clover even tried to woo a couple of them, but they got freaked out and ran away, which really upset her. First I lost my card, and now I can't even snag a cute boy. Could my life get any worse?
I hate it here.
Mikan, go to jail. Well, well, what have we here? Hissed a voice Clover hoped she hadn't really heard. But sure enough. Ugh, Mandy, what are you doing here? Mandy simply scoffed. The real question is, what are you losers doing here? Duh, we're competing in this tournament, sneered Alex. Well, then I guess this is my lucky day, Mandy mocked. Don't you mean mocker, Mikan? I'll get to have the privilege of knocking all three out of here. Yes. All three out you out of here. Oh, please, Mandy, scoffed Sam. Every time we duel you, you always wind up flat on the ground and humiliated. Mandy felt her forehead throbbing with anger. I think you should see a doctor, Mandy.
Go to hospital right away and leave the story.
Go to hospital.
Hospital.
You just got lucky. Only this year, I've got a little secret weapon that's gonna wipe the floor with all of you. She laughed with her trademark snigger, and the girls were starting to lose their patience. Forget her, said Sam.
Me too.
Sam. Let's just go and find Mikan. The others agreed and left Mandy on her own. That when she heard that I was competing in this tournament too, she had nearly lost control of herself. Well, if Mikan's going to be here, maybe I should think about taking him out first. Doctor, I'm afraid you have a terminal case of bad writing. She reached into her deck and pulled out her single newest card. With this little baby by my side, I'll finally get my revenge on that creep as the respect I deserve. Sabrina and I had already arrived in Duel City, and we were searching for the girls. Collective character. I tried to use my Millennium Necklace to locate them, but it still wouldn't work. That same mysterious force was blocking me from using it, which confirmed we were defiantly up against someone using Millennium Magic. But we still didn't know who it was, where they were, and why they were doing this. We'll have to try and find the girls ourselves, Sabrina suggested. Have you tried, like, using a cell phone?
Have you tried playing Warcraft also?
No. Absolutely not.
Hi, Pepper.
Oh, Peepa. Peepa.
Hi.
Peepa Baba.
Hello. Come here.
Peeba.
Hi.
Kitty.
Oh, Joey too. Hi, Jojo.
Two of them.
Hi. Pepper. Yes, yes. Hello. Come here.
Animals.
Pepper. Pepper. Come here. Good girl. Hello. Hello. Yes, yes. Sneeze, sneeze.
Sneep snorf. Verifying identity.
Peeba. Hi. Yes, hello. Hi to you too, Joey. You're across the room, so I can't pet you. But I see you.
Detected.
Oh. Hi.
Don't eat that. Don't eat those papers.
There we go. Yep, we're at that stage of the interaction.
Hi. Hi, Pepper.
May I?
She sits.
May I continue?
Sure.
Right, but let's stick together, I said. I have a feeling there's more to this tournament than meets the eye. Just as we were about to walk out, a large zeppelin was hovering over the city. Everyone gazed up at it. On the sides of the zeppelin were large screens showing images of two hooded figures dressed just like the rare hunters, but were obviously the leaders of them all. No one could see their faces hidden under those dark hoods, but they were indeed the hosts of the entire tournament. It's American Ishizu. As they gave their opening speeches and welcomed everyone, but Sabrina and I couldn't help but feel those voices sounded very familiar to us. Oh my god, it's Aswad and Aswad too! The two siblings finished with their opening speeches, which I guess we don't get to hear. I went over the rules of the tournament, including their favorite one, the anti-rule of losing your rarest card if you lost. But they also explained what the fragments we had were for. They were one piece of six pieces that made a complete and fully functioning key card. As well as our rarest cards, we had to wager the fragments we had in duels until we accumulated all six correct pieces to form a complete key card. Once complete, and when placed on a duel disc, the card would guide us to the location where the finals would take place, and the key card would also be presented as total proof of qualification. So this is something that's bugged me about the locator cards in the original as well, but like, if they're all different, how, like, assuming that there's six different types of locator card and you have to get one of each, how what happens if you get duplicates? Like, does that still work? Or is there more than six? Are they all, like, how do you guarantee that you get a six that work together to actually get you the... Because in the original, they made a map. This more disturbed it meets the eye. Well, first off, it's run by baby kidnappers. Yeah, true.
Jorb, did you just go silent or did something happen to me? Hello? Jorb? Oh. I guess it's just me now. I don't know what's happening. Jorbus Palinorbus, are you here? Can I contact you from the Shadow Realm? I think I might finally got him. This is the most rational explanation for what's going on.